When recording is there, you can just write down the notes with the help of recording also, right? Okay. Now today also we are just moving with collocations. There's a lesson. This is a different lesson. We talked about behavior, sorry, we talked about appearance, right? And we learned lots of collocations. And we did some revisions. And today, at the end of this lesson, I am going to talk about that. And I am going to ask some questions about the first lesson, about the things that you have learned about appearance. And let us start with character and behavior. That also is a big lesson, right? And please write down all the things in details and then go learn them properly. And try to understand everything. In case you have a problem, please tell me, we'll discuss. Now I am going to teach one collocation that is painfully shy. Painfully shy. When I was a teenager, this is an example, right? When I was a teenager, I was painfully shy. Does somebody understand what painfully shy means? You know what shy means, right? Shy is not forward, not outgoing. Just hiding, something like that, right? So, but what is the meaning of that? What do you think about this collocation? Have you heard this? After this lesson, you will start hearing this from a lot of places, even in films, songs. You see, painfully shy. Can somebody define the meaning of painfully shy? Hello? Who is able to say? Abdul, what is your idea about painfully shy?
I think, sir, extremely
Yeah,
shy.
painfully means very shy. But we don't say he is very, you can say she is very shy, it's okay. But the collocation is painfully shy. People say, oh my God, this girl is painfully shy. Something like that, right? When you say painfully shy, English speaking people, native people really understand that. And it is like it's like their country, it is like their language when you say painfully shy. But if you say greatly shy, extremely shy, it's not a charge word, right? They won't get much. They will be emotionally aroused when you say this. Painfully shy, they straight away they'll be touched when you use that word, right? Meaning extremely shy, but we don't say extremely shy, please say painfully shy. Oh, so shy. So shy is very shy that other people find it disturbing. And other people find it disturbing. That is the idea. But metal the pretty pattern is well narrow. අපි ග්‍රැමත් පොඩ්ඩක් ඉගෙන ගන්න එපේ. ඒක ඕන ලියා ගන්න හරි මේ පැටර්න් එක. අපි මෙතන ගන්න මෙන්න මෙහෙම මොනවා හරි මේක so that කියන එක. So that තේරුම් ගොඩක් දිනා. So that I will explain everything. Please write down this so that you may not forget. ඔගොල්ලෝ අමතක නොවෙන විදි පිණිස මේක ලියා ගන්න. So that කියන්නේ එක එක තේරුම් දෙනවා. මෙතනදී මම එක මෙන්න මෙහෙම එක උගන්වනවා. So that I give a space between so. You join two sentences using that, right? So that. Right. How are you going to say that? This sum. What is sum? Sum can ganita getalu. This sum is hard. May ganita getalu amaru. Ganita getalu amaru. No one තමයි ගණිත ගැටලුවක් හදා ගන්නවට අපි කියන්නේ හදනවට කියන්නේ make කියලා කියන්නේ. එතනත් collocation එක. No one can work it out. Work it out කියන්නේ ඒක හදනවා. කාටත් ඒක හදන්න බැහැ. නැත්තම් no one can solve it. එතන මේක අමාරුයි. මේක කාටත් හදා ගන්න බැහැ. එතකොට මෙතන වාක්‍ය දෙකක් තියෙනවා. This sum is hard. කාටත් හදන්න බෑ. මෙතන මෙහෙම දැම්මොත් this sum is so hard. කියලා එතන දාන so අනිත් පැත්තෙන් දාන that this sum is so hard that no one can work it out මේ ගණිත ගැටලුව කොච්චර අමාරුද කිව්වොත් කාටවත් දෙක හදන්න හරි ඒ වගේ අපිට කියන්න පුළුවන් ඉංග්‍රීසි ලේසි ඕන කෙනෙකුට ඉගෙන ගන්න පුළුවන් ඉංග්‍රීසි කොච්චර ලේසිද කිව්වොත් ඕන කෙනෙකුට ඉගෙන ගන්න පුළුවන් කියන්න බලන්න මට ඒක ඉංග්‍රීසි එක කියන්න කවුරු හරි ඉංග්‍රීසි කොච්චර ලේසිද කිව්වොත් ඕන කෙනෙකුට ඉගෙන ගන්න පුළුවන් please tell me that
English is so easy that everyone can learn it.
And then anyone can learn it. One can even learn it. English so easy that anyone can learn it. Why? Khada hana kuchcha lassan jigal madu one thena bina kahan bina pulo. Your voice is so sweet, so beautiful that I can listen to it any longer, right? Any long that I can listen to that any long. Okay. එයා කොච්චර ලස්සනද කිව්වොත් ඕන කෙනෙක් දෙසරක් හැරිලා බලනවා කොහොමද කියන්නේ can you tell me that? please tell she is
so beautiful
she is so beautiful
that anyone
can දෙසරක් හැරිලා බලනවා
Anyone? Look after
him. Turns to look after him. Like a balagan. Anyone? Turns twice or more. Twice or more. This is another idiot. Tara. Anyone turns twice or more to look at her? Why she is so beautiful that anyone turns twice or so, twice or more to look at her. Okay. ඒ වගේ වාක්‍ය ටික හදලා මට කියන්න සෝ දැක් දාලා. අපි හරියට මේ පැටර්න් එක ගල්ලා ගන්නවා. Somebody tell me. How the game? Kumar, you have something? Roshini, Hashini. Prabha, give me sentence. Kya na? Roshini, will you give me a sentence?
This app is so easy that anyone can use.
What is that? What is so easy?
This device.
This device is so easy that anyone can use it. Right.
Yes.
Yes. Or you can say that in past tense also. You can say. IELTS is so easy. IELTS kiyana eka kochchara lesithu kiwoth that I passed it without going to a class IELTS කොච්චර ලේසිද කිව්වොත් රෝෂිනී එක පාස් වුණා පන්තියට යන්නෙත් නැතිව බලන්න රෝෂිනී you passed that you are happy රෝෂිනී is that easy is it so easy hello රෝෂිනී Okay. Anyone Hashini, give me a sentence. Hashini.
Yes, shall I?
Okay. Give me a sentence.
You are so cruel that none can friendly with you.
Yes, you are so cruel. Take a minute. You are so cruel. You are so cruel that none can no one can no one can make friend with you kaadadda eka yaalu velai එතන කාටවත් බෑ යා යාළුවෝ කියලා තියාගන්න. You are so cruel that none can make friend with you. With him, with you. Okay. නැත්තම් none can associate you. Associate කියන ආස්තේ කරනවා. None can associate you. Okay. Who else? Ashini, can you talk? Ashini, give me a sentence.
That sport was so hard that no one could be
understand. Excuse me, I
didn't
get it. Manal, hard you?
Sport
huh?
was
huh?
so hard.
Yeah, I
have
this work.
Yes, I said sport.
This sport. This sport is so hard. This sport is so hard. Please complete.
I said that sport was so hard that no one could get it.
That sport is so hard that. That no one could win it. Win it, Ashini?
Could not got it.
Get it.
Get it, yeah.
Okay. This sport is very so hard that no one could get it. No one could get it means what do we mean by that? No one could learn it. Oh, අපි මෙහෙමත් කරන්න බලමු මේකත් හොඳයි මෙහෙමත් කරන්න බලමු this game is so hard that no one can win it. No one can win it. මේ game එක කොච්චර අමාරුද කාටවත් දිනන්න බෑ. Okay. Some more, come on, give me a sentence. Please.
Essential items are so expensive that anyone reject to buy.
Okay. Essential items. Let's say vegetables. Vegetables are so expensive. Expensive that lot of people have stopped eating them these days. මේ දවස්වල කවුරු දෙනුලු ගන්න හුඟක් කරන ඔය there are vegetable shops in our areas. I have seen that people won't buy. Earlier they buy, you know, old people buy vegetables. Now most of the people they don't eat, they don't buy vegetables, right? Tamarakon, do you buy a lot of vegetables now? You have no problems, no, you are a rich person, so you buy. But what about your poor neighbors, Tamarakon? Do they buy vegetables? Tamarakon? Hello? He's not there. Kumara, what about your area? People, your area, vegetables are cheap?
No, sir. Actually, you know that in our area, that's a village. Lot of things to collect from the gardens.
Yes. If you come to this area with some sack of young tender jack, sack,
yeah,
sack can
baby jack.
Oh, baby jack, sack can what?
Sack
can go. Okay. මේකක් කරගෙන යනවා ටෙන්ඩ ජැක්කෝ බේබි ජැක් වට් එවර් රයිට් ඉෆ් යූ බීන් නොට් ජැක් ප්ලීස් පුට් කේ රයිට් ඉට්ස් අ නෝ ඉට්ස් නොට් අ රයිට් ගුඩ් වර්ඩ් රයිට් ජැක් ඉස් නොට් ඉන් ඩික්ෂනරි ඉට්ස් අ ශ්‍රී ලංකන් වර්ඩ් පොලොස් කියවනම් ඔයිඩෙඩි හොඳයි වැඩ නැහැනේ සුද්ධ වුරු ජැක් කියලා දෙන්නු තේරෙන්නේ නැ පෙන්වන්න ඕන they don't understand what it is right you can say polos if you bring a sack of polos to this area you will be a rich man
maybe sir maybe but
maybe sure definitely can fill your pockets with money one jack I mean little jack is I think 200 or 300 rupees here come with a bag
but sir so we want to sell them at the market or at the road because when we hand over to when we sell it to another person he will get a lot of profit
but don't sell don't take dealers in the middle right just walk from house to house with that jug bag
yes
and you'll be very rich so this is Sri Lanka now
yes sir
but you are lucky that you are in a countryside but
yeah
I don't know these people Nirupa how about you you enjoy going to market to buy vegetables now
but on these days it's very expensive, very expensive.
Yeah, so expensive that you have stopped eating vegetables, or you still eat?
Still eat, sir. But
why don't you stop eating? Then everybody in the country stop eating vegetables. Automatically, price will come down. Right? You think you in Sri Lankan people are so I don't know they are poor, but they are poor in qualities. Poor in qualities. Hey, that Oscar Wilde has said something. Oscar Wilde kila din ekang. Some people, you know, I will tell you that. Some people are. So, may pattern na kailangan naman kailan niya. Some people are so. අතන ඔස්කා වයිල් වැඩයිස් කරන්නේ මේ ඉතින් යා වැඩක් නැහැ දැන් අවුරුදු 18 වෙනි සතවසේ ගොඳර තියෙනවා so he's gone however some people are so poor that මිනිස්සු කොච්චර දුප්පත්ද කිව්වොත් that they have only money උන්ට තියෙන සල්ලි විතරයි දැන් සල්ලි තියෙන මිනිස්සු දුප්පත් ඒකයි තේරුම කිසිම quality එකක් නැහැ you have to have qualities So I want to tell you that I have an experience because I have lived in Italy. I was just lucky to live there because I could understand a lot of things when I lived there. You know, there are people. How rich those people are? I mean, the culture of those people is different. What is salary? Namut. අපි හිතමු වතුර බෝතලයක් ගණන් ඇරිය කියලා රුපියල් දෙකකින් මේ අපි ලංකාවේ දෙක රුපියල් දෙකකින් ගණන් ඇරිය කියලා මොනවා හරි බහන්න ගන්න නැහැ කවුරුත් කිසි වෙලාවක ගන්න නැහැ ඒක සාදා අසාදාම් විදිහට උඩට ගියන කිසි මිනිහෙක් ගන්න නැහැ කෝටි වගේ ගන්නෙත් නෑ ඒ රුපියල් දෙක ගණන් ගන්නේ ඒ වගේ සෝ දැන් ඉතාලි මෙහෙන් එක එක රටවල් වලින් ගිහිලා පදිංචිච්ච අය නම් ගනි ඉතාලි ජාතික එහෙම ගන්න ඒගොල්ලෝ බලනවා මකට එහෙලා ගාන මේක සාධාරණ නැහැ ඊට ගන්න නිකම්ම බිමට වහිනවා ගන්න So in Sri Lanka, vegetables are so expensive. All right, one pod of bean. Arey ka kiu ekka bonji karla rupeeal pahala pe na kira. Eight gun. That's how the mentality of our people are. So when they do like that, they are. They have money, but they are very poor. What is your idea, Kumar?
Yes, sir.
You think it is right? Sure. What I said is right.
Actually, sir, you are correct because you know that our people in Sri Lanka who support for the government, present government, they are if government do something, they approve it. You know that I am remember that I think that before 5 or 6 years in the present government rule, when present government rule was held by
the present government was in power.
In power, that in that time,
yes.
The you know that Mahinda Rajapaksa was the president.
Yes.
Then people strike that don't you know that in one the electricity bill is get high rate.
Yes.
Then some people strike, not don't get it down. Mm. You know, have you remember?
Yes.
That's the that's thing, because our people in such mentality.
Yeah, mentality. Poor mentality.
Yes, poor mentality.
Now they are talking about petrol from India and other countries and a lot of problems. So, එක දවසෙන් මේ ඉවර කරන්න පුළුවන් එක දවසෙන්ම ඔය ඒ ඒ පෙට්‍රල් ගත්තේ නැත්නම් එක දවසෙන් මේ කම්පැනි තමයි. So they are running with the help of these people.
Yes, sir.
Don't go to those things. One day they'll have to go home. But our country, people are selfish and very proud, and they are all the bad qualities of, we know, අපි bad qualities කියලා දන්න જાතියක් තියෙන නරක පුරුදු නරක ගතිගුණ කියලා තියෙනවානේ. අන්නේ
නරක
ගතිගුණ මුළු ලෝකෙම ගිහිල්ලා බැලුවොත් අපි රට මේ ලෝකෙන් උතුම් රට කියලා කියනවා තමයි මෙහි ඉඳගෙන. නමුත් ඕලු ටික එළියට ගිහිල්ලා බැලුවොත් ලෝකෙන් උතුම් රට කියලා කියවල නරක ගතිගුණ කියන ඕම ටික මේ ලංකාවුන්ගේ තමයි. Now you will think about Pakistani people, they just killed one man from Sri Lanka. But if you go into the depth of that person, ඒ මනුස්සයා මරපු එකේ හේතුව ගැන හොයන්න ගියොත් ඒත් ඔයගොල්ලෝ බලයි පාකිස්තාන මිනිස්සු කොච්චර ඉහළින් ඉඳලාද මේ මරණය කළේ කියලා. මේ මරණය කරන්නත් අපි දැන් අපිට ඒ වගේ එකක් කරන්නවත් බෑ. You understand? මරන්න කියන්නේ මේ ඒගොල්ලෝ ඒගොල්ලන්ගේ රට වෙනුවෙන් ඒගොල්ලන්ගේ ප්‍රතිපත් වෙනුවෙන් ඒගොල්ලෝ හිට ගන්නවා. කොහොමද? අපේ මිනිස්සු වෙයිද? එන්නේ නැහැ. ඒක මරණ එක හොඳ වැඩක් නෙමෙයි. ඒක මෝඩකම ආගමක් වෙනින් මරණ එක. නමුත් ආගම වෙනුවෙන් ඒගොල්ලෝ හිට ගන්න. That's it. අපේ කිසිම දෙයක් වෙනුවෙන් හිට ගන්න. පොරකමට විතරයි හිට ගන්න. So that's it. So you understand, some people are so poor, and so is there, that is there. So poor that they have only money, right? Vegetables are so expensive that a lot of people have stopped eating, right? Okay, I hope you understand. And some people are very silent. What about Abdul? Do you have any idea about vegetable, expensive, those things? So can you make a sentence with so and that? Abdul, are you sick today?
Yeah. No, sir.
So why don't
you? Cost of living is so high.
Uh-huh.
So the people... So high that people will face starvation.
Very soon, you're going to say that.
Yeah.
Even then, they will not understand.
People will starve. No, sir.
Starve. They will starve. Very soon people will starve. Starve can harm us till I'm married. But even then, they will not understand. Their brain will not start working. Really, I don't know how to define the situation of these people. All right. We are moving. What does it mean to be painfully shy? What is your idea? If somebody is painfully shy, what will happen? And what is the meaning of being painfully shy? What kind of things that person would do? Please tell me, somebody. supposing your friend is painfully shy, and what will that what that person does, and what kind of qualities that person would have? Can you describe that? A painfully shy, shy person. Ashini. Net Prabha. Please write down painfully shy is the collocation, right? You must learn it. Net Prabha, hello.
Hello, sir.
Is anybody in your family painfully shy?
Yeah, it's me.
Oh, it's you.
Yeah.
Okay, but you are not shy. You talk over. Now you talk in the Zoom class. You can't be so shy.
No, sir. But physical classes. In the physical classes, I am very painfully shy.
Really? So would you like to open your video and talk? No, you are shy. Then.
No, I'm shy.
You keep the video closed, and in the blind class you talk. But at least some people don't talk even like that. So you are not painfully shy. You can be shy, but not painfully. Painfully shy, yes. Painfully shy is actually, you are going to learn that now, right? Okay, thank you, Net Prabha. Maybe Hashini, could you tell me something about being painfully shy? What is your idea about that? Have you any experience, or have you seen other people being painfully shy? Ashini? You have any experience about, or you have second experience? First experience means you, about you, or your family members, somebody's painfully shy? No?
Sometimes I have experience with, I think mostly I'm really shy to in front of a lot of people, physically, doing a speech or something. Mm-hmm. It is really hard. Like sometimes schools give us some projects and something, so you have to do your thing in front of class. Sometimes extremely hard. So I think now it's better than the past.
I'm happy you explained that way. Roshini, do you have anything to add to what Hashini and other Anit Prabha said? Being painfully shy?
Certain things, and mostly I think in my family, my brother is a person who is painfully shy.
When a person is in a family painfully shy, now you have your brother there, and he's painfully shy. And when you have a person who is painfully shy, how do you, what is it like? You think it is very good in the family, or you don't like it? It is positive or negative?
I think it is a negative thing, because when we are staying just like that, it's difficult to know about things. It means in this situation, I think this is in the class, most of children are painfully shy to ask questions from the teacher and present their abilities. So due to that, they are unable to show their abilities. So I think this is a negative thing. And when we have to ask something, we should keep the shy in a side, and we should ask the thing we have to know. So I think it's a negative thing.
Okay, one thing I want to know from you, Roshan. Now I have taken this single collocation, painfully shy, and I talk a lot about that. Do you think it is negative or positive for you? Am I talking too much about one collocation?
I think it is positive, sir.
You learn it?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Somebody else, Kumar, what do you think? Am I taking long time for talking about one collocation, or do you want me to run quickly and finish all the collocations?
No, sir. I think that this is better. You know that this word is that means collocation is a new pattern for us. So you know that you are
The way I conduct the class with that word.
Yeah.
It's okay.
Yes. So painfully shy. I think that this should some person have painfully shy, not for relevant reasons.
Yeah.
So one day.
Yeah. You have the point. There are things that you should be shy about, and there are things that you should be ashamed of. But people are not shy for those things. They are shy for irrelevant things, unnecessary things.
Yes. Yes, sir.
Okay, go on.
I think, sir.
Okay. Yes, come on.
I think, sir, there are two types of there are two sides because. Painfully shy is sometimes good, sometimes bad. As Buddha said that every people will have to shy and fear. That means we are going to wrong things. Actually, we have to painfully shy is better.
Yes. So the other good things, when you want to go in front and show your skills and speak and those things, you should not go backwards. You have to come forward.
Yes, definitely. Okay. If you are going to do wrong things, actually we have to use it is painful size is better.
Yeah. But it never happened in Sri Lanka. Sri Lanka is very different.
Yes, I agree with you, sir.
Even our good monks are also using bad, filthy words. We saw that. Okay.
Without any shy.
Yeah, they are not shy. Extremely shy. Extremely shy individuals are typically low in self-esteem. Low in self-esteem also is a collocation, right? Self-esteem can thamunge matina kama. තමයි සෙල්ෆ් ස්ටීම් කියන්නේ ඒක ගැන තියෙන පහත් හැඟීම. ඒක නේ ලොකු එකක් නෑ. අලියගේ ධර්ම දන්නේ නෑ. They are typically low in self esteem. You understand self esteem means that right? You should know. You should have a having a be high in self esteem also is bad. You'll have to have just right in self esteem. And largely preoccupied with what others think of them. Preoccupied means pre means before. Before thing, before something happened, they think, oh, if I go in front and talk, that person will think about me that way. He will think bad of me. He will laugh at me. And you decide everything before happening and then you stop going there. Driven by fear of rejection. Fear of rejection can a pratikshepa vegan a buyer. Nisa, buying, some of you do one. A buyer, Anua, Egulanati, you know, shy people often engage in self sabotage. A hater is a self sabotage, or then a sabotage can watch enough, so you may watch among him a single and the other than only watch and go to come out with a sabotage can they? Who do they pull again? Bustle a seat, Kapanama, no hurry. Because they have that problem. They think they are they have the fear of rejection. Rejection can predict shape away. And to prevent themselves from growing closer to others and avoid social situations when possible. Right? ඒ වගේම සමාජ සිටුේෂන්ස් වලට යන්න වෙයි කියලා හිතන නිසා ඒගොල්ලෝ ඒකෙන් බලකින් ඒකෙන් අර හිත සනස ගන්න self sabotage කරන මහා විනාශකාරී දේවල් තනියම ඉඳගෙන මීයෝගේ ඉඳගෙන කාඩ නොදැනෙම කරනවා. කියන්නේ මොනවාරි දෙයක් කරනවා කපලා කොටලා දාන්න පුළුවන්. They are very dangerous. So being too painfully shy is not good. Painfully shy means too much of shyness, right? Too much. That's not good. Okay, Nirupa, what is your idea?
That it is very negative thing, I think. I have bad experience about this.
What is that?
Bad painfully shy.
You are painfully shy?
Yes, when I was in school days, I think I'm painfully shy.
Uh-huh. So you are low in self-esteem? You don't understand what you can do. You have underestimation about yourself?
Maybe, sir.
So you have the fear of rejection?
Yes, of course.
Others will reject you.
Yes.
And you are sometimes largely preoccupied. Preoccupied means you think what happened. අර ශාස්ත්‍රකාරයෙකු විඥානක් අවදි අනාගත වෙන දේවල් දන්නවා මෙහෙම මෙහෙම වෙනවා කියලා තමුම්ම දැනගෙන ඉන්නවා
yes
එහෙම අනිත් අය කරයි කියලා අපිම හිතා ගන්නවා මෙහෙම කිව්වොත් මට මෙහෙම වෙයි ඒක තමයි යන්නේ so preoccupied is largely preoccupied that also is a collocation right largely preoccupied kumar have you come across people who are largely preoccupied or you have experience about that are you largely preoccupied
I can't understand your
preoccupied
question, sir.
No. Do you understand this one? Maybe preoccupied.
Yeah.
You understand?
Yes, sir.
That means you take decisions before it happens.
Yeah.
You have that one. Actually, you think if I do this, that will happen. So I am not doing that. Now, you will be in a pre and a para. Before something happened, you think. Are you like that?
Actually, sir, there's another class for my son, so I couldn't hear your problem.
Right. Okay.
He is shouting very highly, so I... couldn't hear your explanation.
So if I say that again.
Okay.
Now I told you that preoccupied means we take decisions before it happens. Right?
Yeah.
You think if I do this, this thing will happen. So I am not going to do that. So මේ වගේ දෙයක් වෙයි කියලා හිතලා ඉස්සෙල්ලාම හිතන වෙන්නේ ඉස්සෙල්ලා කලින්ම තීරණ අරගෙන ඉවරයි. වෙනද? අන්න එහෙම මිනිස්සු ඉන්නවා. ඒගොල්ලෝ ඊට පස්සේ ඒක කරන්නේ නැහැ. ඒගොල්ලෝ මිහිතල ඉවරයි මම මෙහෙම කරපුවා මම ගහට නැගුවොත් එහෙම ওই ගහේ මී වදයක් තියෙයි මී වදින මිනිස්සු මී බැස්සෝ ටික මට ආනි ඊට පස්සේ මම බිමට වැටෙයි. එහෙනම් මම ওই ගහට නගින්නේ නැහැ. උන් නගින්නේ මොනවා? You understand?
Yes sir. So it's like assuming, no? Assuming things.
Yes. Assumptions. Yeah. Okay. Do you understand that? Right. So preoccupied is that. Now I ask from Kumar.
Yes, sir.
Are you preoccupied sometimes?
Actually, no, sir.
You are not.
Because I.
You take the challenge.
Yes.
Okay.
I think that it's my habit.
All right.
I always try to. Challenge for anything, yes.
Then we'll move away.
Because actually, if I think that is correct,
yes.
Then I do it.
Okay.
But I don't like to do wrong things.
Mm-hmm.
Okay,
next one, painfully shy. I'm going to tell you some further thing. You, these people, they are painfully shy, right? You can't talk to them. They never open their mouth. They are painfully shy. They have some problems. And they are like that, painfully shy. Okay. They don't come in front. When they see somebody, they want to run away. Right? There are children like that. They are paying pollution. Okay, Abdul, do you have some last thing to tell me about painfully shy?
Painfully shy means no, it should be corrected in the family and the school, sir. So a child, it's a psychological thing. So it should be from the beginning, from the kindergarten age, this should be corrected. So then the society will be without painfully shy people.
Right.
Society, yes.
Do you have any idea of how to correct these people?
It means because when they move with people, if they go to correct schools, and from the parents' part is very high, sir. In this case, parents' role is plays a major role. Parents, because they the should other, be yeah.
Other thing is you should have teachers. Then teachers yes, are in order. என்னது ஒரு அப்படியே லங்காவே டீச்சர்ஸ்ல இன்னொரு கேக்கத்தான் பிரச்சனை தீர்ந்து ஸ்கூல் ஒன்று டீச்சர்ஸ்ல இன்னொரு கேக்கு டீச்சர்ஸ்ல இதெல்லாம் முகத கரண்டு காத்தே காரி கைவாரோ காகரி இன்னமா இக்கோ நேரம் கொட்டூரே இல்ல மகானவா இவகி இத்தர் பிரிமி குரு ஒரு ஹிரியானி பிரைமரி ஒரு பிரிமி ஹிரியா இகளு குடக் கிளாவட ஒரு லமையம்ம ஹொந்தர ஹெதுவா இக்கன சைக்காலஜி எக்கக் தியனவா இவ தனகன லமேக்கு ஹரியட ஹதனவா டீச்சர் நிகங் அவில்ல பந்தியட ஆவா அடி டீச்சர் கதை கரோ வகேனே தென் கேனோ இதர்னி சோ வி நீட் டீச்சர்ஸ் ගෑනෝ අය හිටියා වුණත් ඒගොල්ලම මොනිටර් කරන්න ප්‍රතිපත්ති තියෙනවා ප්‍රින්සිපල්ස් තියෙනවා ප්‍රතිපත්ති එහෙම ජාතික ප්‍රතිපත්ති තියෙනවා ඒ ප්‍රතිපත්ති වලින් තමයි ටීචර්ස්ලා මොනිටර් කරන්නේ ඒතකොට ටීචර්ස්ලා මෙන්න මේ දේවල් ළමයා විදිහෙන් ගන්න ඕන ඒ ළමයින්ට ෆයිල් එකක් තියෙනවා ඒ ළමයි කෑම කන එකේ ඉඳලා ටීචර් ඒගොල්ලෝ ගැන නෝට් හදන්න ඕන ඊට පස්සේ ප්‍රස්තාර අඳින්න ඕන ඒ වගේ දේවල් ඔය ප්‍රයිමරි ටීචර්ස්ලා කරන්න තියෙන ගොඩාක් දේවල් එක ළමයෙක් ගැන පුදුම අවධානයක් යොමු කරන්න තියෙනවා ඒ ටීචර්ස්ලා මොකද කරන්නේ එහෙම කරනවා එතකොට සමහර ටීචර්ස් ලා ළමයින්ගෙන් පලි ගන්නවා දෙමෝපියොත් එක්ක තරහ වෙලා ළමයින්ගෙන් පලි ගන්න ටීචර්ස් ලා ඉතින් මේ වගේ ටීචර්ස් ලා ලංකාවේ ඉන්නේ එතකොට දැන් ඉතින් සමහර ටීචර්ස් ලා සත්තු වගේ so we can't correct children so we are sending children our children we are sending to animals a group of animals so better you keep your children at home I think then they will be automatically corrected under parents But the problem is parents are also busy because of this economic situation. But schools, I don't know, we have a lot of problems. For parents have a lot of problems because of their children from schools. The biggest problem comes is the teachers are taking revenge on children. Samara demopi loku pantiyala 10 11 pantiyala ළමයින්ගේ සමහර කර ටීචර්ස් ලා පලි ගන්නවා. ඒ ළමයින්ට ස්කෝල් එපා කරනවා ටීචර්ස් ලා. So you should understand all these things. And Kumar, do you have any idea?
Actually, sir, but there must be a they should be social. Then they have to. Go to school, but I agree with you because some teachers have a lot of problems in families,
yes.
And they are coming to school as such level that you taught. But some teachers are in families; they are very. Not cruel. They are not cruel. They come to school very calmly. So they actually look after the children that I told the baby children. Then they think that they are. Son, no daughter.
Okay. Okay. Kumar, now you tell me what job is great or hard? Teacher's job or mechanic's job?
Teacher job, sir.
Mechanic job is not hard, right?
No.
Hari. Even a mechanic can have a car. උට ගෙදර ප්‍රශ්න තියෙනවා ගෙදර ප්‍රශ්න අරගෙන ඇවිල්ලා කාර් එක හදනකොට කාර් එක පුරන්න හදයිද අර ගෑස් ටැංකිය වගේ එහෙම හදන්නේ නැහැ කාර් එක හරියට හැදුවා නැත්නම් කාර් එක දුවන්නේ නැහැ ඒතර ටීචර් කියන්න පුළුවන් මට ගෙදර ප්‍රශ්න හින්දා මේ දරුවා මං කාලා දානවා කියලා
නෝ සර් there's a mind yes there's a mind for the teacher you know because I have some experience about it
yes.
some teachers are very cruel because from their home situation they have to face for a lot of problems at home one of them they have lot of works they have lot of works and their economy also the next problem
so I am telling you those problems can't affect the job that is it and the other thing eka 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 ekulu dala karanawa eka dala karanne mokada e job eka bara ganna hinda ne me ahinsaka lamai ne e lamaya teacher hariyata karanna nadda kiyala dannae lamaya ithin teacher king job eka bara ganna e unata mama car eka hadanna giyama mage car eka kaewoth man mechanic te nikan inna da oluwata deyak denne nadda man mage car eka kala
no sir then after that the mechanic have no jobs you know that
eka da I am coming to that point So, Kumar, it is not the problem of the teacher.
Yeah, the problem but, is the teacher. You know that teacher? You know, yes, I agree with you. Yes, but teachers have a salary from the government.
No.
But mechanic has not a salary from the government.
No, government they have to, that's not a problem. Yes. I was a teacher in school, so I could tell you what I did in a school. So, that's a different story. So, we did a job of work.
I agree with you.
Yes. Now, mama, magen kisima lame pota nobalupu lame inne. Mokada api eken hata karala ne. So, there should be superiors. Etana eka monitor karana kattiyak inne pe. Egullo e ihala ehema kenek nae ne ihala inne pissune. Ekaṭa me job ekak kawadaka hariyanne nae. Mokada meka dan balanna mama English guru hari. Oya guru assawada mama giyane school e. තොර මම ෆස්ට් ක්ලාස් එක සෑහෙන සත්කම ඉස්කෝලේ ඒ ගෲප් එකට ගියා කිසිම තැනක ඔය ජොබ් එකේදී අර ඕ ලෙවල් ඒ ලෙවල් අර ඩිග්‍රී කියපු ඒවයි මිසක් කිසිම තැනක මගේ මට ඉංග්‍රීසි කතා කරන්න පුළුවන්ද කියලා ඔය රස්සාවේ බලලා නැහැ ඒ කියන්නේ කිසිම ගුරුවරයෙක් ඉංග්‍රීසි කතා කරන්න පුළුවන්ද කියලා බලලා නැමේ ඉංග්‍රීසි ගුරුවරුම ගන්න ඉතින් ඒ ඉංග්‍රීසි ගුරුවරුම ඉන්න ලෝඩ් එකක් මෙන්න ඉංග්‍රීසි කතා කරන්න බෑ ඒතොර ඒගොල්ලෝ කොහොමද තව කෙනෙකුට කතා කරන්න උගන්නන්නේ එතනින්ම සිද්ධ right you understand There are so many teachers. They can't speak for at least 5 minutes in English. So that kind of teachers are there. It's not the problem of teachers. Guru room give aradhane me. Guru room make a bandhu ganu ko deko lo. He me niiti dal kero. Guru room tamu mahada ganu tamai. He me deko pulwa minute itara yein. So that's the problem. Okay, that's a very big problem, and it is going to be a so long thing. So we have to finish it anyway. So we go away from this. Next one is if you have a vivid imagination. Onna den api ena vivid imagination kiyala. Reha reete. Prashai. If you have a vivid imagination, you are able to imagine ideas, images, etc. very easily. So here the collocation is vivid imagination. Actually, have a vivid imagination what is the idea ara do kiyanna pulam abdul can you explain what is to have a vivid imagination what is the meaning of vivid abdul hello abdul
yes sir sorry sir vivid means It's like a bright, brilliant.
Brilliant and living, sajeevi, jeevamana.
Yes.
Or when you say you have a vivid imagination, what is the meaning? When you say you have a vivid imagination, the meaning is you are able to imagine ideas, images, etc. very easily. Itin mawagan hondara puluwan. Vivid imagination ekak thiyena kene. Labi ara kiyanne ki dan hondata mawala චිත්‍ර වගේ හිතින් මවා ගන්න ඔක්කොම ටික ඔළුවට ගන්න පුළුවන් කෙනෙකුට අපි කියනවා මෙයාට හොඳ විවිධ ඉමේජිනේෂන් එකක් තියෙනවා කියලා. He has a vivid imagination. Right? So that is the meaning. But we have to go to we have to get more meaning. We have to be, you know, we have to make this word ours, like painfully shy කියන එක අපිට දැන් ඇඟටම ගියාවනේ. ඒ වගේ මේකත් ගන්න ඕන. So we have to talk about this a lot. So vivid imagination. I have a vivid imagination කියලා කවුරුහරි කිව්වොත් ඒකේ තේරුම එයාට අදහස් රූප බොහොම ලේසියෙන් හිතෙන් මවා ගන්න පුළුවන් ලස්සන වර්ණවත් දේ. ඒ කියන්නේ ඇත්තම වගේ හිතෙන් මවා ගන්න පුළුවන් නම් එයාට කියන්න පුළුවන් මට vivid imagination එකක් තියෙනවා. හරි. හරි. එතකොට අපි තව බලමු මේකේ විස්තර කරන්න තව ටිකක් දුරට ගිහිල්ලා. Vivid imagination. Right. I loved reading books. Mama pot kiyawana asa. And I had a vivid imagination. That means I had a creative and colorful imagination. Somebody is having a creative and colorful imagination. He can say I have a vivid imagination. So this is the meaning. I had a problem with the presentation. So I loved reading books. I had vivid imagination. When you say vivid imagination, the meaning is you have creative and colorful imagination. So, Nirupa, tell me what is your idea about vivid imagination? Do you have a vivid imagination? And do you know anybody who has a vivid imagination?
I think sometimes I had vivid imagination when we read a book. I can imagine the characters of that book and a situation of the writer the situations. I think I can I have vivid imagination. I think so. So many people can have that this behavior.
When you read a books, the characters come to your head live, right?
Yes.
Then who has the powerful imagination? You or the writer?
That writer, yes.
Definitely. Who enjoy writer's vivid imagination, yes. Right? It is the vivid imagination of the writer. Yes. You might use your intelligence and reflect on his imagination.
Yes, yes.
So, but it is the imagination of the writer.
Yes.
You have vivid imagination, you must be able to write a book or do some piece of art. But anyway, there are other talents counted. However,
when we watch a film also, that director's image. So that, yes, I can understand.
Yeah, it's the vivid imagination of those people, right? Yes. Okay. What about Samarakon? What is your idea about vivid imagination?
Vivid imagination means if some dramas telecast in the TV like this, sometimes end of the day. We can vivid imagination what will happen next week.
Right. That means you watch the teledrama for the first day, and after that you have the vivid imagination, and you know how it is going to be ended, and you stop watching it.
Yes.
You watch
yes,
it. You save your time because of your vivid imagination. Yeah, I understand.
Yes. Telecast like that, teledramas in Sri Lanka.
Yeah. So you have vivid imagination about this, about their end.
Yes. We can vivid imagination what will happen in the next week. So
you don't have to
stop the watching. Yes.
You don't stop watching. And you save your time.
Yes.
Okay. Very clever. What about others? Hashini, what is your idea about vivid imagination? Do you have a vivid imagination? How are you going to reflect on it? Hashini? What is your contribution?
I might have a vivid imagination. Vivid imagination means like we can imagine some ideas like writing a book, so we can build up a story with our imaginations and write down. So I think that's vivid imagination. Like others said before, like when we are reading a book or watching something, like we can also imagine like what happen, what will happen after that. So.
Yeah. Okay, that's good. Okay, there are so many things. When you say vivid, you like Samarakon said that he will think about the end of the drama. Is not actually, it's not vivid imagination. Vivid imagination is the liveliness of the characters, and you think you see them as large as life. Nikan ettama wage peenawa. Eka thamai vivid imagination kiyanne. Etta wagema peenawa. එහෙම මිසක අර අනාගතයේ හේ තෙලිනාට් එක මෙහෙම වෙයි කියලා හිතා ගන්න එක ඒක ප්‍රියෝකුපේෂන් රයිට් ඔර් එල්ස් යූ කැන් සේ යූ හිතලා ගන්න ඒ ඉමේජිනේෂන් එකේ තමයි බට් මෙතනදී විවිඩ් ඉමේජිනේෂන් මීන්ස් දැට් අර ඇත්ත වගේ හිතින් මම ගන්න පුළුවන් කියන එක තියෙනවා ඇත්ත වගේ කියන්න සෑ ඒකදී අවසානය ගැන හිතනවා කියනට වැඩිය ඇත්තට මෙහෙම සිදු වෙනවා වගේ දැන් හීනියක් දැක්කා වගේ හීනේ නිකන් විවිඩ් imagination එක ගන්න මේක නිකන් ඇත්ත සිද්ධියක් වුණාම කියනවා අන්න ඒක ඔකේ අබ්දුල් have you got to tell me something about vivid imagination Roshini
actually sir vivid imagination is a vital thing but so in the vivid imagination so we can remember means we can think more things and we can grasp it very easily but at the present situation because of these devices the vivid imaginations have diminished as the so I think we because in those devices we can see the pictures and we don't have to imagine anything So, but in the subjects, just like literature, English literature, Sinhala literature, the teachers always try to means they know the students are unable to imagine those things because of that reason they have established those subjects also. So, more than those in other eras at the present, this thing has shown. So, I think. If we can improve this, I think it will be able to do many things.
Yeah, by improving in vivid imagination. Okay. When you say you have vivid imagination means, now when you move with people around the society, you really experience meeting those people and looking at their faces and their clothes and you even... smell their perfume or whatever, right? And then you hear their sounds, their voices, right? You hear other sounds around. And all these things can come into the mind of a person if that person has a vivid imagination, right? So it is like he is experiencing a real life situation. That is the real meaning of vivid imagination. Okay. Then Net Prabha, do you have to tell me something about vivid imagination?
Sir, actually, I have a vivid imagination. Because of that, I can write essays, poems beautifully. And when I was reading books, I feel it real, and sometimes I feel very sad, and at that time I cry.
Yeah.
Actually, in our family, me and my father have a vivid imagination, but my brother haven't it.
Okay. What your brother has?
But my brother haven't vivid imagination.
He hasn't. Okay.
Yeah.
All right. So you said that you just came out with a nice point, some nice point, very important facts that when you read a book, you start crying. That is because your imagination. That's the vivid imagination. And you really feel that some person dies or some person is experiencing very sorrowful or pathetic situation, and you feel very compassionate towards that person. You move with compassion towards that person, and that is because of your imagination, vivid imagination. So actually, I think it is very good example, right? You are experiencing as you experience in life. That is the vivid imagination. What is an example of a vivid imagination? Can you, Nirupa, can you give me an example of vivid imagination?
Actually, I couldn't. I will tell you later, Samita. I have to think about that.
Okay. Anybody? Kumar, what is an example of vivid imagination?
Yes, sir. Actually, I think that in our country, the politicians have vivid imagination, then country will be developed. Yes. I think that in ancient people, that kings of our country, had a vivid imagination. So they could develop our country very well. So you know that most of them, when they rule the country, they always thought about the nation, and they could develop the country very well.
They thought about the nation, and present people think about the commission.
Commission, yes, you are correct. So they had vivid imagination, you know, the king Dutukyamunu and King Parakram Bahu, that such rulers had vivid imagination, so yeah, they could develop our country. Because actually they don't think about themselves. Yes. They didn't think about themselves.
Yes.
That's my idea about it, sir.
Yeah. Now these people want to develop their self. They want to develop their families. And they don't understand when you climb up a tree and sit at the end, one end of a branch and cut from the end, that joins the stem of the tree. Then what happens?
Yeah.
With the branch, you will fall down. So their families and everything will be developed, and they will have a good time in this country. But the whole country goes down at the end. The pathetic situation will become of them also. Their children also will have to suffer at the end. They won't be able to do anything with the money that they have in their hand. That will be very little when the real situation comes. So, yeah, I don't know, we don't have to talk about that. However, example of vivid imagination can be something like this. I'm just giving you example, means sentence, right? He had a very vivid imagination and was a good writer. So, he had a very vivid imagination and he became a writer. Then, another sentence, Avia is a bright girl with a vivid imagination, yet she is mocked by her peers. Mocked can yaar samajh chal gaya na, passive voice wali de ne. She is mocked by her peers. Peers can age saman aaya. Mane meka, I will tell you, mewa uganna peya unata mama nikan oy yama kerala podi ekak uganna menne mewa samanak welawata. You have to learn it, right? Then balanna. I told kiyanne mokada? I told kiyanne mama kiwwa. Hari? Mama kiwwa kiyanne thamai I told kiyanne. එතකොට I am කියලා මෙතන තාවොත් I am told කියලා කියන එක આવොත් ඒක passive voice. ඒක කියනවා මට කිව්වා. දැන් මේ subject එක මොනවා හරි කරනවා නම් මෙතන subject එක මොනවා හරි කරනවා. එතකොට ඒක active. මෙතන subject එකට යමක් සිදු වෙනවා. එතකොට ඒක passive voice. Passive voice කියන්නේ කර්මකාරකය කියන්නේ සිංහලෙන් කර්මය කාරක කියන්නේ කරනවා. කර්මය තමයි කරන්නේ. කර්තෘකාරක කියන්නේ කර්තෘ තමයි කරන්නේ. දැන් individual කියද්දී active voice කියන්නේ වොයිස් එක කියන්නේ කතා කරන පුද්ගලයාගේ හඬ ඇක්ටිව්. ඒ කියන්නේ සබ්ජෙක්ට් එක තමයි මොනහරි කරන්නේ. පැසිව් වොයිස් කියන්නේ මේ කතා කරන පුද්ගලයාගේ හඬ පැසිව්. එයා මොකුත් කරන්නේ නැහැ. එයාට යමක් සිදු වෙනවා. ඒක තමයි ඇක්ටිව් පැසිව්. එතන මේකේ මූලික දේ තමයි මේ විදිහට එන්නේ. දැන් අපිට ඕනනම් මෙහෙම කියන්න පුළුවන්. We eat rice කියන්නේ අපි බත් කනවා. We eat rice. එතන මේ අපි කරන දේනේ. දැන් ඕක පැසිව් වොයිස් දෙමුත් එහෙම වෙන්නේ මොකද්ද? Rice but ඒක ඒකෝජනක ඊස් දානවා ඊට් කියන එකේ past participle එක ගන්නවා rice is eat but කනු ලබනවා ඒ කියන්නේ but වලට වෙන දේ හැම වෙලේම ඒතර මෙතන තියෙන්නේ she is mocked කියන ඇයට සමච්චල් කරනවා නෙමෙයි ඇයට සමච්චල් කරනවා සමච්චල් කරනු ලබන මේ තමයි passive voice කියන්නේ එහෙනම් passive voice කියද්දී හැබැයි මම කියන්න subject එකට යමක් වෙනවා active කියන්නේ subject එකට යමක් okay මම ඒ වගේ සමානක් අවස්ථාවලදී ග්‍රැමර් ටිකක් කියලා දෙන්නම්. දැන් ඉස්සරහට අපි පොඩි ග්‍රැමර් ටිකක් කරන්න වෙනවා. අපි කරලා තියෙන්නේ අපේ බේසික් එකේදී. නමුත් මෙතනදී අපි ග්‍රැමර් ටිකක් පටන් ගන්නවා. දැන් මේ දවස්වල අපි යන්නේ කොලොකේෂන්, right? Okay. Then next sentence. Moosel has a vivid imagination which makes him believe in monsters. අර vivid imagination එක ගත්තම ඒකෙන් හින්දා යා monsters ලා. ඒ කියන්නේ රකුසෝ ගැන එයා විශ්වාස කළා රකුසෝ ඉන්න පුළුවන් කියලා මොන්ස්ටර්. He has a vivid imagination and has a strong desire to learn things. අර vivid imagination එකක් තිබ්බා. එයාගේම දැඩි ආශාවක් තිබුණා එක එක දේවල් ඉගෙන ගන්න. Okay. So we'll read them. මේ තමයි sentences. මම කියන උගල මට පස්සේ කියන්න. He had a very vivid imagination and was a good writer.
He had a very vivid imagination
and
was a good writer.
Okay. Abhya is a bright girl with a vivid imagination, yet she is mocked by her peers.
Abhya is a bright girl with a vivid imagination, yet she is mocked by her peers.
එතන මෙතන යෙට් කියන එක සමානයි යෙට් කියන කුළු දැනගන්නවා යෙට් කියලා දිනන කොහේ හරි යෙට් කියන එක සමහරක් වෙලා තවම කියන එක යෙට් කියන එක තේරුම නමුත් සමහරකට මේක සමානයි බට් කියන මෙතන ඇවිල්ලා තියෙන්නේ බට් කියන්නේ බට් she is mocked ඒ කියන්නේ ඇයට සමච්චල් කළා by her peers peers කියන්නේ අපි කියන්නේ peer groups කියලා කියන්නේ සම වයස් කණ්ඩායම් කියන්නේ සම වයස සමාන අය තමයි peer කියන්නේ ඒක සම වයස අය යට ඉලුගලා Moosel has a vivid imagination which makes him believe in monsters. Yes.
Moosel has a vivid imagination which makes him believe in monsters.
He has a vivid imagination and has a strong desire to learn things.
He has a vivid imagination,
and has a strong desire to learn things.
Okay. Then we move away. If you describe memories and descriptions as vivid, you mean that they are very clear and detailed. ඔගොල්ලෝ මොන හරි විස්තරයකට කිව්වොත් එහෙම vivid කියලා අපි අදහස් කරන්නේ මේ විස්තරයන් හරිම vivid කියලා අපි වචන දැම්මොත් ඒකෙන් අපි අදහස් කරන්නේ ඒ විස්තරය හරි පැහැදිලි ඒ වගේම ඒකේ තොරතුරු ගොඩක් අඩංගුයි කියන එකයි. ඒ කියන්නේ ඇත්තට වදින විදිහට අර එකෙන් ඇත්තට සිදු වුණා වගේ. හරි විවිධ කියලා කියනවා. විවිධ කියුවහම නිකන් සජීවි ජීවමාන කියන අදහස තමයි. People of my generation who lived through the World War II have vivid memories of confusion and incompetence. අපේ වයසේදී අපේ අපේ પરම්පරාවේ අපේ પરම්පරාවේ my generation people of my generation මගේ પરම්පරාවේ මිනිස්සු who lived through world war 2 දෙවෙනි ලෝක සංග්‍රාමයේ කාලේ ජීවත් වෙච්ච මගේ પરම්පරාවේ සෙනග have vivid memories ඒගොල්ලන්ට හොඳ සජීවී මතකයන් තියෙනවා confusion and incompetence confusion කියන්නේ අවුල් වියවුල් වීම සහ නොහැකියාව ගැන කිසි දෙයක් කරන්න බැරුව ඒගොල්ලෝ ලත වෙන කාලයක් තිබුණානේ අන්න ඒ ගැන ඒගොල්ලන්ට ලොකු incompetence එක ගැන competence කියන්නේ හැකියාව incompetence කියන්නේ නොහැකියාව දැන් world war එකේදී අසරණ වෙලා හිටපු කම සහ අවුල ගැන ඒගොල්ලන්ට හොඳ vivid imagination එකක් තියෙනවා ඉස්සර කාලේ අපි කියන ලංකාවේ අර පෝලිං යුගයේ හිටපු අය පෝලිම කියද්දිම සිහි නැති වෙනවා. ඒගොල්ලෝ දන්නවා පෝලිං වල හිටපු හැටි. එතකොට පෝලිං වල හිටලා හාල් ගත්තු හැටි, පෝලිං වල දෙගෙන බඩු ගත්තු හැටි, බඩු අර මුද්දරයක් දීලා මුද්දරේට පාර භාගයයි දුන්නේ. ඒ වගේ එහෙම කඩවල වලින් සල්ලි තියාගෙනත් කන්න නැතුව හිටපු හැටි මිනිස්සුන්ට මතක් වෙනවා. එහෙම පෝලිවක් දකිද්දිම මිනිස්සුන්ට ඇඟට වදිනවා. ඒගොල්ලන්ට විවිධ ඉමේජිනේෂන් එකක් තියෙනවා. හැබැයි දැන් අද කාලේ ළමයි දකින්නේ නැහැනේ. එහෙම පෝලිං දැකලා නැහැ. ඒගොල්ලෝ ඉස්සර කාලේ පරිප්පු කාලා නැහැනේ. එතකොට අද කාලේ අය ගැන හිතා වෙනවා ඒගොල්ලෝ දන්නේ නැහැ ඔහොම පොලිම ටිකක් බැන්නට හරිම පොලිම ආවොත් එහෙම සාගරයක් ඇවිල්ලා අර ටින් එකක් අතේ තියාගෙන ගිහිල්ලා ඇඳුනොත් නැතුව මේ පොඩි රෙදි කැල්ලක් ඇඳලා ඇඳුමක් තරින් සල්ලි තුනක් ගන්න නැහැ ඉතින් ටික තියෙන සල්ලිත් නැතු වෙනවා බැංකුත් එක පාරක් කඩා වුණොත් ඒ බැංකුවල තියෙන සල්ලිත් අතරවත් ගන්න හම්බෙන්නේ එතකොට ඒවා තේරෙන්නේ නැහැ මිනිසුන්ට ඒවා රස කොහොමද කියලා ඒවා අත්දැකීමක් විවිධ ඉමේජිනේෂන් එකක් නැහැ අර පරණ දේවල් ගැන ඔයගොල්ලෝ ඉන්ටර්නෙට් එකෙන් හරි හොයලා බලන්න ඒ කාලේ ෆොටෝ බලන්න මිනිස්සු කොහමද පාරවල් වල හිටියේ කියලා ලංකාවේ මිනිස්සු ඒවා ඉන්ටර්නෙට් එකට ගිහිල්ලා බලන්න ඉන්ටර්නෙට් එකේ ෆොටෝ තියෙනවා ඒ කාලේදී මිනිස්සු පේරියට අම්මා එක පොලිමක තාත්තා එක පොලිමක කන්න නැතුව මේ වගේ මහතර හිටියේ නැහැ මිනිස්සු හරිම කෙට්ටු මිනිස්සු විදිහේ කෙසඟ මිනිස්සු ලංකාවේ හිටියේ මේ දර කෑඩි වගේ අතපය තිබුණු උදේ ඉඳලා හැන්ද එනකන් තේ ඌරක් බීලා තේ කහර ටිකක් බොනවා හකුරු කෑල්ලක්වත් නැතුව නිකන් හට විතරත් ඒගොල්ලෝ ඉස්සරහ ඉඳලා. එහෙම දේවල් ගැන මිනිසුන්ට විවිධ ඉමේජිනේෂන් එකක් තියෙනවා නම් මිනිස්සු අද මේ වලට ඉඩ දෙන්නේ නැහැ. දැන් ඉතින් තවදුරටත් ඔහොම යන්න කියලා ඉඩ දීලා ඉන්නවා. අනේ අපිට වෙන්නේ නැහැ නේ තාම කියලා. ඒ වුණාට මිච්ච දාට මතක ඉදි. ඒක තමයි විවිධ ඉමේජිනේෂන් එකක් ඕනේ. Right. On Wednesday night, I had a very vivid dream which really upset me. මට හරිම පැහැදිලි හීනයක් මම සජීවී හීනයක් දැක්ක මේ බදාදා කියන්නේ ඒක නිකන් ඇත්ත වගේ හීනයක් දැක්ක ඒක තේරුම. අපි විවිධයකට ඕන නම් ඇත්ත වගේ කියලා කිව්වොත් ඒත් අදහස එනවා. ඇත්ත වගේ හීනයක් දැක්ක ඒක මාව මාර විදිහට අවුල් වුණා ඒ හීනේ දැක්ක. මේ ඇත්තටම වෙන වගේ දැක්ක. අපි කියන්නේ විවිධ කියන වචනේ. මම දැන් විවිධ ඉමේජිනේෂන් එක විතර නෙමෙයි මම මෙතන කියන්නේ විවිධ කියන වචනේ පාවිච්චි කරන හැටි. ඒතර විවිධ කියවම සජීවී විවිධ හිතා ගන්න පුළුවන් ඒ වගේ දේ. Okay, then I think that's over. So do you have anything to add? Anyone? Kumara? Do you want to add anything?
Actually, I think that Sri Lankan people have vivid idea about our politician.
What will happen in the future, in few years? What will happen? Yes. Only some people have that idea. Most of the people have.
Not allow them to come to the power.
Allow them to come to the power. නෙමෙයි කුමාර ඒක හරියට දැනුණා නම් එහෙම මෙහෙම ඉඳගෙන ඉන්නේ නැහැ මේ Zoom class කර කර ඉඳගෙන ඉන්නේ නැහැ. එහෙනම් අද රහුවට මණ්ඩ පිහි කැටි පුළු වරගෙන ගිහින් මේක අදම ඉවර කරනවා. එහෙම ಐඩියාවක් නැහැ. අපි ගියොත් එහෙම අපි විතරක් ඉඳි එල්ලිලා කොහෙටද? එහෙම මිනිස්සු නැගිරෙන්නේ මොකද කොන්දක්වත් නැහැ නැගිරෙන්නේ නැහැ එහෙම අදහසක්වත් නැහැ. අන්තිමන බෙල්ල පාගනකම්ම දන්න. එතකොට නැගිරින්න බෑ. ඉදාට ඉතින් නැගිරලා වැඩකුත් නැහැ නැගිරින්නත් බෑ. ඒ වෙනකම් ඉඳගෙන ඉන්නවා. ඉතින් Zoom class කරයි ඉතින් ඔය චුට්ට තියෙනනේ පොඩි පොඩි හිල් ඉතින් ඒවයි උඩුව තියාගෙන ඉන්නවා. නැත්තම් හරි අදහසක් තියුනනම් මෙහෙම ඉඳගෙන එක විනාඩියක් ඉඳගෙන ඉන්න ඔක්කොම නැගිට මුළු රටම නැගිට. So they don't have any idea. Current එක වැදුනවා කියන එක හිතින්නේ. හරියටම දැනුන්නේ. නේද? මොලේ චුට්ටක් වැදුනොත් පුදුම වේවි කොහෙද ඉන්නේ කියලා.
ඔසර දැන් අත අපි ගත්තාම සාමාන්‍යයෙන් ලංකාව දැන් වරුදු 70 ගණක් ඉස්සේ පාලනය කරනවා නමුත් ඉතින් අත වශයෙන් මේ ප්‍රශ්න එකක්වත් ඉවර නැහැ නෙන්න දෙන්න වැඩි වෙනවා මිසක් හැම දෙයක්ම ප්‍රශ්න නැහැ දැන් මේ ඊයේ පෙරදා අර පාර්ලිමේන්තුවට ඇවිත් ගැටුමක් අන්තිමට මේ ඒකත් උනේ කමිටුවක් දාන්න තීරණය කළානේ ඒක සංසිඳවන්න මේ කමිටුවටත් විඳන් කරන්නේ මහින්සක ජනතාවගේ සල්ලි
සල්ලි හම්බ කරගෙන ටිකක් කරගන්න ඒක वाहन लक्ष लक्ष देखल उदय कैमरे लक्ष है पणहाई डबल कैमरे लक्ष सी कमी को मेकल ये गाने So there is no end of talking about those things, but there is no use talking to people who don't understand. Nobody understands this, right? I don't know why. Right. So what is your idea about Vivid? Did you learn it properly? Harshini, did you learn Vivid, Vivid imagination and the word Vivid? Harshini?
Yes, sir.
You have no problem about that? No problem. Okay, Nirupa?
Yes, sir. Understood.
Yes means you have a problem.
No, I don't have problems.
So everything is really for you. Really clear.
Yes, clear.
Right. Right. Samar, go on.
I don't have a problem, so I couldn't understand.
You want to ask any question? No, you your ideas
about politics.
Not politician, Vivid.
Yes, politician has good Vivid because they are going to earn lots of things. They are generation. They always need. Imagination about their family. Okay. They are not thinking about the country. Most of people nowadays, most of people saying so many things. President's parents, not only present, past. That means Kumar said that past 72 years, lots of leaders leading country. But nowadays, many people suffer from them.
Yeah.
But the situation, country situation.
But Kumara, people in this country will suffer. Right? They will suffer forever. Yes. They will never stand against suffering. Because these people are so timid and chicken-hearted. So there is no point of talking about them. There can be some people, there are some people. But they are little, very little in number. They can't do anything. So that is a very big problem. Otherwise, in different countries, if these things happen, those governments won't last. Right. Now, who? Abdul, do you want to tell me something?
No, sir. Everything clear, sir.
Everything clear. So then we moved. My best friend, the other one is outgoing personality. That is the next collocation, right? My best friend had a more outgoing personality. She liked to be outgoing personality means she liked to be friendly and sociable. Right? If somebody is friendly and sociable, we say outgoing. She has an outgoing personality. And if you have an outgoing personality, that means you like to talk to people and have friends and like to go to parties and like to be sociable. Roshini, are you outgoing? Do you have an outgoing personality? Roshini? Hello, Roshini? Do you have an outgoing personality?
Can you explain that?
Outgoing personality.
Yeah, if somebody is within brackets, you see, if somebody is out having outgoing personality, that means they are very friendly and they like to go out and they like to go to parties. They like to talk to people. They like to make friends everywhere, right? And they are very sociable and they talk to people. Right? That is something like opposite of painfully shy. Right? They are not shy at all. They opposite of shy, outgoing personality. Do you have an outgoing personality?
Yes, sir. Sometimes I think I have an outgoing personality.
Why do you say you have an outgoing personality? Do you like to go? Do you like to go to parties? Do you like to make friends? Do you like to talk to others?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So tell me experience being outgoing.
Yes, as you said, I like to go out and go to trips and to go parties and chat with my friends and talk to them with their gossips and those things. So in certain times I like to be silent, but most of time I think I'm an outgoing person, and I think I have that outgoing personality.
All right. What about Harshini? Do you have an outgoing personality or you are a shy person? Harshini?
I have outgoing personality, but I'm not sure because sometimes I like to be alone in my room and just listening to some songs and just be alone. But most of the time, I like to go out and talk with my friends, go to parties, and do some fun stuff.
All right. Abdul? What is your idea? How are you?
I think, sir, I have an outgoing personality.
Mm-hmm. Why do you say you have an outgoing personality? You're like that?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Husiru, are you there?
Yes, sir.
What kind of personality do you have?
I have that personality, sir. Outgoing personality. I think I have that personality. Oh. Because I like parties and meet more friends and going trips.
Going on trips.
Going on trips.
Oh. So you have an
I like to speech. Friends' wedding.
You all want to deliver speeches at friends' weddings?
Yes, sir.
You have an outgoing personality.
But sir, but they don't like that. But I like that.
They don't like what? You come and talk about them at the wedding.
Yes, sir. You
talk bad about them.
Bad, sir.
Huh? That's so.
Yes, sir. Past. Things.
They are past and their history. You have the history.
History, the girlfriend's history.
Oh, good. So they don't like that. Deliver that speech.
Yes, sir. Drink and speak. Drunk and speak.
Uh-huh. But even they don't give you a chance, you just grab hold the chance and do it by force. Is that?
Yes, yes, sir. Of course, sir.
You never miss the chance.
Other friends are very
shy.
Like that, yes.
Shy. You are not shy.
No, yes, sir. No, sir. Shy. No, other friends are like my speech.
Okay. Only
others
the,
are like my speech.
Only the relevant person doesn't like. Other people
doesn't enjoy. Like. Yes, very well, very, very well enjoy. That time, that all of drunk time, no?
Yes. Okay.
They like, that's very happy. They are very happy.
You make them happy.
Yes, they make happy.
You are a hell of a person. Okay. outgoing. You pronounce this like this, outgoing, outgoing. Right? This is not go, this is g-o-ing, outgoing. That means friendly and socially confident. Confident can atmavishwasathi, friendly, socially and confident. There are examples. She's always been very outgoing and she's got heaps of friends. Heaps can go down. Togiyak inna, yaru togiyak inna, load of friends. Heaps of friends, they are same meaning. Right? Many friends. And then, the adjective outgoing describes someone with a friendly, easy personality. They become an easy personality. Easy can serious ne. එච්චර ලොකුවට ගණන් ගන්න නැති පර්සනැලිටි එකකට මිත්‍රශීලී ඕනෙකට හලෝ කියන බොහොම නිකන් අර ලොකුවට පුම්බගෙන ඉන්න සීරියස් ඉති නිසා ඊසි පර්සනැලිටි එකකට අපි කියන අවුට්ගෝයින් යෝ අවුට්ගෝයින් ෆ්‍රෙන්ඩ් මයිට් නොට් අන්ඩර්ස්ටෑන්ඩ් හවු හාඩ් ඉට් ඉස් ෆෝ ෂයි පීපල් ටු ස්පීක් ඉන් ෆ්‍රන්ට් ඔෆ් ඇන් ඕඩියන්ස් ඔය අවුට්ගෝයින් අයට තේරෙන්නේ නැහැ ඕඩියන්ස් එක ෂයි කෙනෙකුට කතා කරන්න කොච්චර අමාරුද කියලා වෙනවද outgoing nahi danne oda dana katha karanna oda kenoda puluwan kiyala but shy people find it very difficult and outgoing people don't understand how difficult it is for shy people okay Niruba what is your idea being outgoing and shy
yes earlier I said when I was in my school days I'm so painfully shy person but in at the moment in the current situation when I was starting my
job.
Yes career and it's a change
you have become yes. outgoing now
yes now become outgoing person because but for my job I have to talk to the other people because I have to talk to the customers and not only Sri Lanka but overseas customers so it's really big change about my life when I was starting this job so I think it's very good but in this description like I have no so many friends but I like to friend with other people and sociable and talk with people and because that's my job so because I should have to talk to the people and when a company has a problem I should have to talk to the persons and clear it out because that I think I build up that outgoing personality at the moment.
So now at the moment you have an outgoing personality.
Yes.
Okay. That's good. Right. So, all right, we'll see the other one. People who are outgoing are perfectly comfortable in social situations. Outgoing people have no problems in social situations, parties. Social situations, parties, and other people gather. So those are social situations. So outgoing people are perfectly comfortable. Comfortable means it's very good for them. No problem. How outgoing situations are these, right? You talk and laugh and all these things. But do you think outgoing people are sometimes unhappy because they go and talk to people and make lot of friends and at the end they will understand these people they laugh with us and they talk to us but actually they are not with you at heart right when you have a problem you don't have even a single friend right? You might have lots of false friends they are not real friends you have so you might be surrounded by friends and they'll be laughing with you but you should have a problem then nobody is with you so at the end you will understand being outgoing is just making other people laugh and making other people happy and you're just wasting your time Tamarakon what is your idea
yes sir Actually, I have an outgoing personality because it is better without this. We can't live in a new society because we can't control others. Most of people like that people because otherwise, society people can't live with others because other people reject them.
Right. That's your idea. Harshini, do you want to tell me something? Harshini? Harshini? Okay. Netprabha, do you want to tell me something about being outgoing, having an outgoing personality?
Actually, my brother has outgoing personality. Because of that, he likes to make friends always. And he has very easy personality, I think. He's very sociable person.
What about you?
I haven't outgoing personality. I'm very shy.
Right. Your mic is sometimes going down, right? Be careful about your mic. First part was okay, but second part was not okay. All right. Now we are moving. Right. Outgoing, and after that we are going to come to another thing. But before that, I would like to give you a little time for your speeches. Does somebody want to do a speech? Right. Do you want to do a speech? Who is going to do a speech? Abdul, what have you drawn here? Abdul.
Sorry, sir.
Okay. Can you draw again? Draw a line again. Can you draw?
Sorry, sir, my mistake.
You can't draw now? Okay, I have given you an annotation. Now I stop the annotation. Now you can't draw. However, can somebody make a speech? Oh, Samargon, Kumara, Nirupa.
Netprabha. Yes, sir.
Want to do a speech? Uchiru? Anyone? Harshini? Harshini? Who's going to
do? I am going to speak because. Yes, shall I speak?
Okay.
Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yes, I am going to speak. Today I don't have prepared a speech, but I am going to. Speech about the country of the situation. Actually, when we think about the current situation in the country, we have most of people suffer about the country and ruling the people because of actually in our past we lived very well. When we think about our children and others, actually, we have to think badly because what will happen their future? That's the main situation. Most of parents think about that because we can't. We will have to face lots of problems nowadays because everything is. Prices and everything day by day very increased. That means most of people can't live because they can't get even one time also. Labors also suffering so many things. They suffered. That means our leaders. The leaders don't care about that. They want to earn lots of money. They are going to develop their families and any other thing. They don't care about that the people. At the end, already our country goes down day by day. Most of past politicians and present politicians responsible for this situation. That's all.
Okay. Anybody else? Let Prabha, you want to talk? Anyone ready? Hello? Nobody? Kumara?
Today, sir, I couldn't prepare for it.
Then what about Net Prabha?
It's an important thing. Every living being should need water. Without water, we can't survive in the world. So it's a vital thing for every living being. So when we are talking the uses of water for our day-to-day consumption, the water is an essential thing, just like cooking, cleaning, washing, bathing. For those essential things, we need water. And for the section of agriculture, it's a vital thing for the agriculture. And entertainment activities also what is an essential thing. So some sports, just like swimming, boat races, for those sports also relevant with the sport, with the water. So I think water is an important thing for that also. But at the present situation, multitude of people used to pollute this and they don't have any idea about we should prevent this for our other younger generation, other generation. And they are used to pollute this by doing several kinds of things. So actually at the present situation, there is a 0.01% of water which we can use, but they don't have any idea about it. And they used to pollute it. So I have to express that we should prevent this because we need water. We can't measure the how it is important for us. It's actually it's a resource. So we should protect this unless at the future it will be a big problem for us. We have to stay without waters and multitude of problems have come for us. So I think we should stop this. And I have to tell, we should protect the water, we should take care of it, and all the person should think about this.
Okay, very good. Right, now we are going to, I am not giving any comments on your speeches, right? So I let everybody listen to that, and you have the recording, you can listen to that again. But I shall not say anything about your speeches, because I should let you speak freely, right? Even if you make a grammar mistake, even if you make anything, I'm not telling you at the speech, but I listen to that, and in my next lessons, I shall prepare lessons for you to correct those mistakes. I shall not comment about this. All right. Sense of humor. Sense of humor is a noun. What do you understand about sense of humor? Net Prabha, do you have an idea about sense of humor?
No, sir.
No. Harshini, what is sense of humor? Hello, Harshini. Okay. Nirupa? No? Susit, do you understand sense of humor?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Tell me.
Sir, humans have more senses.
Yes.
I have.
You have sense of humor?
Yes, sir. But they can't get all sense.
Mm-hmm.
They can't do all sense.
Mm-hmm.
Not for humans, sense have, animals have sense. humans have their children.
Okay, thank you very much. Sense of humor, yes, it's a noun. And my best friend had a good sense of humor. Sometimes we say had a good sense of humor. So sense of humor is a noun. A person's ability to perceive. What is perceive? Perceive is understand. Perceive humor or appreciate a joke. Humor එකක් ඒ කියන්නේ හාස්‍යයක් තේරුම් ගැනීමේ හැකියාව සහ විහිළුවක් අගය කිරීමේ හැකියාව තමයි අපි sense of humor කියන්නේ. එහෙම එකක් තියෙනවා
නේද? sense කියන්නේ හැඟීමනේ.
ඔව් හැඟීම sense of humor කියන්නේ collocation එකනේ. ඒ කියන්නේ collocation එක ආවහම ඒකේ තේරුම් තුන වෙනස් වෙනවා. sense of humor කියුවහම කෙනෙක්ට විහිළුවක් තේරුම් ගන්න පුළුවන් නම් ඒ විහිළුව අගය කරන්න පුළුවන් නම් එයා අපි කියන අර sense of humor එකක් තියෙනවා කියන්නේ. නැත්තම් අපි විහිළුවක් කරුවම ගියක් තරම් කොටන්නේ නැරනම් එයාට sense of humor එකක් නැහැ හරි එහෙනම් පරිස්සම් වෙන්න ඕනේ එයාත් විහිළු කරනවා නම් අන්න ඒකේකට sense of humor කියන she has a great sense of humor අර හොඳ sense of humor එකක් තියෙන කෙනෙක් හොඳට විහිළු කරලා ඉන්නවා how do you use sense of humor කොහොමද අපි මේ sense of humor පාවිච්චි කරන්නේ can somebody give me answer දැන් ඔයගොල්ලෝ දන්නා sense of humor කියන්නේ නම් විහිළු තහළු කරලා ඉන්න විහිළු වඳුරලා එහෙම ඉන්න දන්න කෙනෙකුට අපි කියනවා he has a sense of humor. දැන් මට මේ question එකට උත්තරයක් දෙන්න how do you use sense of humor? කොහොමද අපි sense of humor පාවිච්චි කරන්නේ?
So that's depend on time. Various times gathering people's.
Yes.
Party times.
Not while we are working.
No. Of course, sir.
Okay. Does it the nurse was expected to be friendly and have a sense of humor? Nurse කෙනෙක් සාමාන්‍යයෙන් බලාපොරොත්තු වෙන යම් මිත්‍රශීලී වෙලා නිකන් විහිළු වදප ගන්න nurse කෙනෙක් ඉන්නවා sense of humor. The writing is fluent. මේ වාක්‍ය ටිකක් දෙන්න මම. The writing is fluent and engaging and often displays a dry sense of humor at work. One key quality of lexicographer needs, he says, is a sense of humor. Right? Then his sense of humor and respect for others made him an ideal friend one can ever dream of. කෙනෙකුට ලබාගත හැකි හොඳම වගේ පුද්ගලෙක් හරියට ගැළපෙනම යාළුවෙක් තමයි එයා. මොකද යාගේ තියෙන sense of humor සහ අනිත් අය ගරු කිරීමේ ගරු කිරීම. එහෙනම් යාව ඒ වගේ පටින් යාළු ඉස්සරහ. So sense of humor is that, right? What are all of your senses? Humans have five basic senses. අන්න එහෙම තව senses කියලා තව වචනයක් තියෙනවා. Five basic senses. ඒ කියන්නේ සංවේදන. ඉන්ද්‍රියන් අපි කියනවා. ඒවට කියනවා touch. Touch කියන්නේ ස්පර්ශය. ඊට sight කියන්නේ දර්ශනය. ඒක දැකීම. Hearing කියන්නේ ඇසීම, smell කියන්නේ ගඳ සුවඳ දැනීම, taste කියන්නේ රස දැනීම. ඕවට තමයි අපි කියන්නේ five senses කියලා. සංවේදන පහ. Sense of humor කියන එක වෙනම කතන්දරයක්. විහිළු තේරුම් ගැනීමට පුළුවන් දෙයක්. ඊට පස්සේ sensing organs කියන්නේ අපේ associated with each sense. අපේ sensing organs මොනවාද? නහය, ඇස් ඒවා හැම එකම මේ එක එක senses අදාළයි. And send information to brain. Indian අපිට මොලේට සංඥා යාම. Help to understand and perceive the world around us. ඊපස් අපි වටේ ඉන්න ලෝකේ අපි තේරුම් ගන්න යන්නේ ඉන්ද්‍රියන් වලින්. මේ සංවේදන සහිත ඉන්ද්‍රියන්. ඒ හැම එකක් ඉන්ද්‍රියකට පුළුවන් අපිට මේ සංවේදන ලබා දෙන්න. Right? එතකොට then we are going to move into other one. Totally sense gain. So we are going to stop here. Sense of humor. So what is your idea about senses of you? Senses of humor and all these things. Do you have anything to tell me, Kumara, about senses?
Actually, sir, it's good for people, but this characteristic has no for animals. For this is only for people.
People can laugh. Animals can't laugh.
Yeah, because the
sense of humor is among people.
Yes, among people. This is good for their health also.
Yes.
Then they always in very happily.
Yeah.
I think that it's good for all people, but they doesn't they should not care about their responsibility in their duty and exit others, and but they must be have a sense of humor, because it's I think that they can live with every person, because they can collaborate with others also. But some people have no sense of humor. They can't
enjoy
with others.
Okay. Now the other one is five basic senses. That also you should remember, right? Do not confuse basic senses with your sense of humor. Sense of humor එක ඒකත් එක කලව පටලවා ගන්න එපා. Touch, ස්පර්ශය, sight එක, hearing, smell and taste කියන ඒවා අර සංවේදන පහ එක ගන්න නැහැ නේද? That එක ඒ සෙන්ස් එක කලප ගන්න පටල ගන්න එපා. So I'm going to wind up the lesson today.